Hey, what's going on, guys? Kurosama here. And today we take a look at the Mobile Doll May. Man, oh man, there's a lot to talk about this. Well, it is a $22 skin for your mobile suit that comes with three EX skills that basically replaces your previous EX skills. Now, I don't know how most people feel. Me personally, I'm kind of whatever about it. It is a little bit too much. Maybe even little is an understatement. I personally believe it should be anywhere between maybe $4.99 and maybe as low as like a dollar. This is something that it's pretty good to have a feature like this because a lot of unique mobile suits cannot be separated into different parts. So instead, giving it a skin can really, you know, bring unique mobile suits into this game. Now, taking a look at it up close, it looks really good. I really don't have any problems with the aesthetics. I like the Mobile Doll May, and especially when she debuted in the episode over in Beldivers Re:Rise. She looks good, man. I don't really have any problems. So instead of taking a look at the max value, we're going to take a look at the level 1 value of each of the EX skills. Now, for the first EX skill, it is going to be an Awakening Liberation. So this one in particular is really good. The main thing is like the first time is going to be 18 seconds. Now, what you're going to get in terms of increase is you're going to get your speed increased by 20%, melee and shot attack 30%. That is fantastic for a level 1. Honestly, this is really something this thing needs in order to actually put any kind of value onto that $21. And next we're going to have is the Rise and Dive. So this is going to be a minus C, which are really pretty much good. It's a finisher attack as well, so it has the animation. Raises attack and shot attack by 15% each. And that's your squad. So that's that's fantastic. And I wonder if this actually is going to stack with the Awakening. It should. I'm just kind of questioning if it really does. Now for the next EX skill is going to be the Double Saber Shear. This is basically just one of your regular like slashing EX skills, nothing too fancy, A minus D, but it is a quick EX skill coming in at 3 seconds for its initial cooldown. Pretty good, and it's a beam melee oriented, so get your traits ready for that. Now, whenever you're utilizing this mobile suit, you basically put it on top of another mobile suit that's already existing. Now, since this does have essentially melee-oriented EX skills, you're going to want to center this around a melee-oriented suit. Now, also, as you can see, I have mostly traits except for the Astray Red Frame Legs, but you can have a total of 9 traits on this MS plus the 3 default EX skills. That is fantastic. That is like super overkill. I'm going to readjust it later, but I really just made this essentially for the traits. I was like, hey, what can I really do to boost the traits? The one that I can really get rid of is essentially like the Age Titus duo, but he was just a really good infighter because I don't have Domonkashu yet. I really wish I had him. But yeah, I mean, for Sengoku Astray, I mean, in fighter EX skill, you got the piercing increase for the Barbatos arms. I mean, you got melee power increase. So it's like looking at your suit, you really have to like figure out what are you trying to do with the skin. And since it is melee, that's pretty much what I'm focused on. And here, I just want to give you a full body shot. So she's very slender, really cool looking. I love the aesthetics. Kind of feels out of place in this game, not going to lie, but looks really good and gets me actually a little bit more excited to get the model. Okay, and now we're going to go into a match to showcase all the X skills. Now, while they're cooling down, I did forget to mention what, wear tags you really want to get. You got to go for Pro Tag and you got to go for Close Combat, and that's what I got on this one. Now, all my EX skills are almost charged. We're just waiting for my Awakening. All right, there we go. Liberation, and now I got that buff. And I'm going to use the regular EX skill a little bit too early, but nonetheless, that's the way it looks. I mean, it's really good, a barrage of beams. And we're going to just take out some enemies before we use our final EX skill. Her mobility is really good, really fast. I mean, maybe there's no difference with her and other suits, but to be honest, I feel like she's a little bit faster. Okay, we're going to take out this Age 2. There we go. Right in my sights. So rise and dive. Really, really cool finisher. Lots of just small damage, but not like a crazy amount. All right, guys. Well, that's pretty much it. My final thoughts, I mean, it's a really, really good skin. The only downside about any of this is that price. That price is, I would just say, too high. If it was coming at like $5, I mean, hey, I actually wouldn't mind. I'll spend the $5 to get it. It's a really cool skin, great EX skills. You can use up to 9 traits. I mean, this thing can be really good, but I don't think it's overpowering things like Bisect, or, you know, if you have like the Trans Am Raid. You're probably not going to be doing more damage than what you can with those other EX skills. But regardless, this is still really fun to have. It's a really cool, like, little addition to the game. And I'm actually looking forward to more. Just hopefully they're going to be priced reasonably. But other than that, guys, you know, I know some people are wondering where I'm at. I'm still playing this game. I just don't really post content of this game. But in the coming months, I'm going to try and do more. But that's it for me, guys. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.